Yeah. restore such a one. In the spirit of meekness, considering thyself, lest thou also be tempted. Bear one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of Christ. For if a man think himself to be something, then he is nothing. He deceiveth himself. And let every man prove his own work, and then shall he have rejoicing in himself alone, and not in another. For every man shall bear his own burden. Let him that is taught in the word communicate unto him that teacheth him all good things. Be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. For he that soweth to the flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. But he that soweth to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap life everlasting. And let us not be weary in well doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. This is the word of God, and the people of God say amen.
Amen.
Good evening, church. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, in the name of Jesus, God, as we come before you this evening, Father, we give you thanks, God, we give you praise, God.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. And we are so indeed blessed.
continue this time of worship. We have some declarations tonight. I would just like you to repeat after me as we make these declarations to the atmosphere we're here. I know that we are here to serve our God. I will be passionate, energetic, and enthusiastic about the things of God.
Prayer.
bishop, my husband, including my husband, Bishop Gailey Swann, pastors, ministers, national directors, church ladies, ministry directors, our special guest speaker, Dr. Tom, Minister Smith, committee members, women ministry directors, visiting friends, brothers and sisters, good evening. I give God thanks for the blessings He has given to us over the years. Over these many years, to come together and enjoy His presence together. For the last few years, we have moved forward in leadership of Ministers Marilyn Colley and Damaris Thompson as they made every attempt to address the spiritual and relational needs of our precious women. Without any doubt in my mind, we have seen God manifest His presence in a great and transformative way. During these two nights, in fact, during these few nights, last night, tonight, and tomorrow night, I believe that we will experience God in a fresh and exciting way. I believe we will experience God in a fresh and exciting way. He will move us from deep down inside of our being and taking out everything that needs to be taken out while He will place everything we need Him to place inside of us. He has promised to wash us with clean water and give us a heart to please Him. Are merely for those who need deliverance and those who are facing great troubles and stress. We must not narrow our focus, but see the bigger picture that God is interested in each and every bit of us, even as He's interested in all of us together as a body. We must not let the opportunity slip by us by ignoring needs, because if we let them go unattended, they will become weights, slowing down our progress. We ought to be excited that God is a need-meeting God. And when He does, we should have the biggest and greatest celebration we can with gracious compassion and provision. Time to give God praise. Come on, give Him a hand clap. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I love to drive fast. There's a great feeling of pressing the accelerator and feeling the power of the car move forward. I must always remember that speed without control can cause undesirable consequences. The one thing I have learned is that experience can be helpful if we pay close attention. To be behind the driver's seat and not be in control of the car is an experience I've learned to appreciate under certain conditions. If the road is wet and the car starts to slide, there's a way to bring it under control. Pressing the brakes might cause more problems. How many know that? But when we start sliding spiritually, we start picking up bad
we must keep in mind that our destiny is ordained by God. Let us be clear in our hearts that we belong to Him, and we must keep the way clear. We must not have anything between our soul and our Savior. I mentioned in our program, Welcome to You, that we have experienced much from the storms. We must not forget to pray and help those affected by the storms. We must be wise in our conversation and committed to being good witnesses of God's wonderful love. Too many times we observe levels of dissatisfaction, unproductivity, and anxiety, and say nothing and do nothing about them. We are being summoned to action by giving an appropriate reply.
rises to her feet and takes another dash. Her faith ignites in one flash.
She runs, remembering that despite the pain, Christ died and rose, there was much to gain. That her work was not as unto man, that was not in the master's plan. For God she must serve and tell him. That is effective living again and again. So despite the death that mocked her world, finances escalated, sickness came at her door, frustrations, depression made her hit the floor. Not on her knees, but lying in despair, thinking only of fear of the unaware. She gets up and keeps running despite the drama, remembering that Christ is a mighty fortress, which is the best shield of protection she has ever
frustration gets out.